Hi viewer, welcome to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through mathematics form 3, lesson number 4. The topic it is quadratic expression and equation 2. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudhoni. Welcome. The lesson goes for today, we are going to derive the quadratic formula, and we start using it to solve the quadratic equation. For the quadratic formula, before we come to deriving the formula, we need first of all to recall the quadratic equation, the way it is expressed. Like you can be able to see on the screen that we have the quadratic general equation, which is the ax squared plus bx, then plus c, which is equal to 0, where a is not equal to 0. Use the completing square method to solve for the equation. So that is the one that we use in order for us to now to get the quadratic formula. This is the way it's supposed to be. We need to use the completing square method to solve the general equation of the quadratic equations. So we have the equation, the first equation, which is ax squared plus bx plus c, which is equals to 0. Where now we need to get the incomplete equation, which we are going to take the C to the other side. So we get the first thing we are going to divide. We are supposed to divide everything by A. So we get the x squared plus b over ax is equal to negative c over a. So the next step you get, it's supposed to be x squared plus b over 2ax. That is, we are trying to complete the equation. Plus b over 2ax, then plus b over 2 squared, which is supposed to be equal to the negative c over a plus b over 2 squared. Whatever you do to one side, do it to the other side. So using the grouping method, we factorize. So we get the x plus b over 2a squared is equal to negative c over a plus b squared over 4a squared. So with that, now we find the square root on both sides. That is the reason as to why we get x plus b over 2a is equal to the plus or minus square root b squared divided by 4ac divided by the 4a squared. So with that, now we take our b over 2a to the other side. So it becomes a negative. That is the reason as to why we get x is equal to negative b over 2a plus or minus the b squared minus 4ac divided by 4a squared. So with that one, now we get that x is equal to minus b plus or minus the square root b squared minus 4ac, then divided by the 2a. So with that, that is the formula we use. We refer to it as the quadratic formula that we use to solve the quadratic equation. So that is the formula, and that is the one that we take. X is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus the 4ac divided by the 2a. So using the quadratic formula, you are required to use the formula. That is the formula, still the formula that you are supposed to use. We have the formula on the screen. The first thing, when we are using the quadratic formula, the first thing you need to identify. So the step that you're supposed to follow when now using the quadratic formula to solve the equation, identify the first thing, it is getting the equation in the correct form, standard form. Then number two, identify A and B and C. Then the next thing, it is you plug numbers into the formula. Where there is a B, replace with B. Where there is A, replace with A. Where there is C, replace with C. So with that now, from there now, we simply solve the equation. We can solve using the calculator or using the other method. We need to get an example. We have an example there that you are supposed to use the quadratic formula. Use the quadratic formula to solve the equation. We have 2x squared plus 11x then plus 7 is equal to 0. In that case, now your A, B, and C are there. A is equal to 2, B is equal to 11, and C is equal to 7. Replacing them in the equation, you happen to get negative 11 plus or minus the square root of 11 squared minus 4 times 2 times 7, then divided by 4 times 2. So in that case, now you get the equation as negative 11 plus or minus 65 divided by 8. So with that, now you happen to get x is either 66 divided by 8 or x is equals to the 54 divided by 8. So with that, now you get is supposed to be either 8.125 or 6.75. That is the way it's supposed to solve using the quadratic equation. You happen to get the roots that we get, they are determined, or we can get the roots in three ways. Either b squared minus 4 is, in case it is less than 0, we can get that. If at all you happen to solve the b squared minus 4 is the number in under square root, you get it is less than 0. That one have the root. But we can have b squared minus 4ac. B squared minus 4ac. If at all it is equals to 0, then it has the real roots, or it has the solutions. It gives a single solution. Or you can also get b squared minus 4ac is less than 0, which it doesn't have a real root. If at all it is less than 0, it doesn't have root. But if at all it is greater than 0, it has root. If at all it is equal to 0, it has root. So in that case now, that is the way you solve the quadratic equation using the quadratic formula. So the assignment for today, you are required to use the quadratic formula to solve the equation. X squared minus 4ax plus 3 is equal to 0. And 9p squared plus 24p plus 16 is equal to 0. The reference where you can get more of these, it is from the KEDB 2003 Secondary Mathematics Student Book 3, the third edition. If at all you want to get us, contact us through these numbers, through the SMS, SMS to that number, through the YouTube, through the Facebook, and also through the Twitter. You can tweet us through that number. So otherwise, stay tuned to Erin TV. Thank you.